and welcome to
the- I'll tell you when. Preparing, I'm sorry.
No worries.
It's rolling. It's usually.
We're good. Hello, everybody, and welcome this afternoon to the Henderson Middle School Transitioning to Middle School series, parent series over the summer. So we're going to go through and have each person introduce themselves and tell them a little bit about who they are, a little bit about their background, and then we'll go ahead and start the presentation. So first up, we've got Ms. Gilmore.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ms. Gilmore. I've been at MEH for, this is my third year, and I'm originally from the Midwest, so from Iowa, was living in Minnesota for a couple years, and I'm excited to see all you all.
All right, next up, we got Ms. Philmeyer.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tara Philmeyer. I'm starting my fifth year at Henderson Middle School. I've been a school counselor in Northern Virginia for 13 years, and I'm excited to be here today.
And I'm Matt Sowers, your host today, the director of counseling here in the middle school. Been here for over 20 years and love being here in Falls Church. I was a former teacher here in the middle school and a counselor for about 15 years. And this will be my first year in the director role. So join us as we give some information today about transitioning to middle school. So you've just met all of our counseling department, but we also wanted to kind of highlight and point one of our main points of contact that you'll probably learn about is Ms. Karina Avila. She's our registrar, and she helps me especially stay in line and keep our entire counseling department organized. And then soon we'll be bringing on a part-time school counselor to join us as well. So we wanted to kind of introduce everyone to our newly revamped school administrators for our building. So kind of looking through these, we've got Ms. Valerie Hardy, our principal of the building. She's been an educator now for about 22 years, and this will be starting her fourth year at Henderson Middle School. Mr. Carey, he's one of our assistant principals. He's been an educator now for about 11 years and will be starting his second year here at Henderson Middle School. And Mr. White, he's an educator for the last 12 years, and he's going to be assigned to working with all grade levels as well. And this will be his first year as an assistant principal. And he was a former special education administrator here in our building for several years. And we're happy to announce that we've promoted within Miss Brittany Allen Shaw to become our next special education administrator. She's been working with the eighth grade team for the past several years. And she is transitioning from being a special education teacher. And we welcome her and all of our administrative team supporting all of our students and working with you as we move into our next school year.
Okay, so we wanted to touch base a little bit about friendships. Middle school is a time of gaining new friends, meeting new people, potentially changing groups, who you're friends with, and that's okay. You're gonna meet a lot of new friends in middle school. The circles change, you will go through a lot of ups and downs, but it's a new time to find new interests, and you, your child, will change interests all the time. And then we also offer a lot of virtual clubs. So over the summer, we had a lot of teachers that started virtual clubs. So, and then we will also carry them over into the fall. And then some of the clubs that we had, Mr. Sowers and Ms. Philmeyer both held some clubs. And so they're going to talk a little bit about what they looked like. So Mr. Sowers, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Gilmore. So the virtual clubs was an initiative that we put forth to support families during COVID, because we found a need to support students remaining tied into our school community, building relationships with other peers, and keeping in a close connection with the staff in our building. One of the ones that I've thoroughly enjoyed running over the summer was called Secret Life of Pets, where I've been able to highlight my newest family members to the Sours Five, which is Brick and Bonsai, two new pug puppies. And we log in with students each week for about a 30-35 minute session. Students talk about their pets, and we kind of commensurate over the highs and lows of being pet owners, and then also bringing on students that do not have pets and kind of share and bring some joy to their day. Ms. Philmeyer, you want to talk a little bit about your group that you've run?
Sure, thank you. So over the summer, I taught a yoga class or sessions of classes, and it was a really great opportunity for the students to come together and get connected. We worked on breath work to help with relaxation. Each week we focused on a quote for reflection, and then we moved through a yoga sequence. Many times the poses were poses that the students were interested in learning or practicing, and they were able to see each other on the screen. And what was really cute is at the end of the session, once we were done with the series, they wanted to exchange phone numbers so that they could FaceTime and practice yoga together. So even though we were virtual, we were still able to establish some connections for the students.
Thank you. So that's what we plan on doing as we're virtual, is continue with those groups. So our students do have that connection and can have a little bit different outlet of, instead of just doing homework, they can focus on something else and potentially try something new. And then while we are in person and in school, we have a variety of different clubs that kids can join. There's not, a lot of them don't have a commitment. So you can try one out and maybe it's not for them. It's something out of the box that they would never try. And if they don't like it, they don't have to go back. But it's fun for them to try different groups. A lot of the groups that you can do, some of them included student council, makerspace, running club, hiking club, best buddies, model UN, band club, and just a lot of different kinds of clubs that you can join. This year, we'll be having a pack time. So on your schedules, you'll see that your student is enrolled in pack time. So this is your social emotional learning class. Your student will have a group of 10 to 15 classmates in there with a staff member. And this will be the time for them to build connection in the school. So they will talk about things that might be bothering them. They could be doing team building activities. When they're virtual, this will be meet two times a week. So this will be Mondays and Friday mornings. In each week, they'll have different curriculum that they'll be doing. And it'll be the same set of students each week throughout the whole year. So they can build that relationship within that community and with the school. And it'll highlight personal and school relationships. They can talk about certain challenges that they might be having. Maybe there's certain tests that are coming up that they want to talk about. And this is going to be that safe place for them to have that like connection and be able to open up with the staff member and with other students in there. Mr. Sours, is there anything else, especially with PAC, that I missed?
I don't think with PAC, other than the way that when we start the school year in a virtual schedule, it's going to be on Mondays and Fridays for that 55-minute timepiece. But then as we transition, hopefully to the hybrid schedule or the fully in-person schedule, then the pack time will transition to an everyday piece so that students can feel, build that sense of community, have that established relationship with a staff member that's consistent each and every day. And then the only other thing that I would highlight is the virtual clubs and the student activities will be linked into this presentation. So when after the presentation is videoed, parents and staff and other people in our community and students can log in and look at the presentation and click on all the hyperlinks that'll take you to other resources.
Okay, so our next slide is talking about organization. So obviously this is a hot topic for students, you know, always, but in particular in middle school. When students are transitioning from elementary to middle, there's a big period of change where they go from having maybe one or two teachers to having seven or eight teachers throughout the school day. So this slide just highlights some of the tools that we have here at Henderson to help keep your student organized. And of course, if your student is struggling, please reach out to us counselors throughout the year so we can keep your student in a good spot. But our first tool is Schoology. And Schoology is our online platform where each student has their own Schoology page. And in each Schoology page, the student's courses is populated. So the teachers each have a folder. For instance, let's say it says Math 6. So the math teacher would place her assignments in there, any useful videos. And this is also where the teachers will be posting their classes. So this is where you will go in and you can access the virtual teachings. It is helpful to use your student's Schoology account when you're helping them. So parents can sign up for their own Schoology, but I highly recommend that if you are helping your student to go in with them under the student version so you can see what they see, and it is the easiest way to navigate that tool as a family. The school will also be setting a uniform way for all teachers to post to make sure that it is even easier to navigate this year as we start with a virtual schedule. In addition to using Schoology, we highly recommend a daily schedule. So having your student kind of map out what his or her school day will look like is very helpful. So of course there'll be the school schedule, but then even after that, what are they doing for fun? When are their breaks throughout the school day? Are there any activities that they're still able to do? And this is a really good tool to help them practice time management and also to help them problem solve if, for example, they have a couple things that are scheduled to happen at the same time. Using an agenda is a really great skill to teach a middle school student. So some students really do well with a paper agenda where they map out their classes and they write down what assignments they have due or what projects they have coming up. So it really helps with that short-term and long-term planning. Other students really prefer an electronic agenda. And this is just, again, another tool for them to do the same thing, but because of their preference, they might enjoy doing it electronically. We also recommend using highlighters or colors as another way to keep the agendas organized. Having a study space is really important, especially as we're in a virtual setting. So we want to make sure that each student has a designated spot, if possible, that's quiet and comfortable and inviting and allows for them to engage in their learning in a way that is not going to create a ton of distraction. You may want to consider having comfortable seating or fidgets in order to help the students stay engaged, but also at the same time balancing not having too many items in that space that may distract them. Having a system for the documents that your student will receive is an important thing to establish. Before school starts or in the first few weeks, once you get a hang of what will be coming their way, if you're printing items at home, make sure you have a folder system. Again, marking it clearly using colored folders is helpful, or using the Google Drive and organizing the folders in that way. Again, labeling them clearly, putting them in a way that makes sense, whether that's in alpha order, whether that's in color order, or if that's in the order of your student's school schedule. Eventually, when we get back in the school building, all students will be assigned a locker. And this is a very exciting thing for many middle school students. And this is another great tool in order to help them stay organized throughout the day. So they're not carrying everything with them. They will carry just what they need. And then we often help students organize their lockers so that there's space for their folders, their binders, their notebooks, their lunches, and any decorations they may have. So once we get back into the building, we will definitely be helping out all students with the transition and of course with getting them a locker and helping them organize it in a way that makes sense for them.
Next part that we have here talks and highlights about the importance of keeping a daily routine. So following a schedule, as Ms. Spillmeyer just talked about, is extremely important and probably one of the most important things that our families here locally are interested in is finding out when their student schedule becomes live to the public for viewing. All of our schedules will become live for our middle school students that are returning to our school on August 14th. Through PowerSchool. So families can log into PowerSchool and be able to see exactly what their classes look like. And then we eventually will have a scheduling template where families can do it independent out of school or within our school time. We will have time built in for us to take a student schedule and put it into our scheduling template so students understand when to log into their classes in a virtual setting. Taking breaks is also important. Even though we know when students are going to be in classes for roughly 55 minutes long, there will be times in the day and after school hours when students will have opportunities for whether staff are checking in through academic advising or students are doing independent practice on their own. Breaks are immensely important to work for a set period of time. A lot of times we'll say work for about 20 minutes and then take a 10 minute break and then continue this on throughout an hour time when you're sitting down doing independent work. Oftentimes we recommend a timer, whether it's through a phone or through a laptop or an old timer in your home to use so that it helps keep you focused and being able to sustain the ability to continue moving through the items that students are working on. Also creating checklists. So Ms. Spillmeyer kind of highlighted the importance of staying organized. In the presentation, we have created some examples of a digital checklist and what that might look like. So after the presentation, feel free to jump back in to the slideshow and select the examples to see what a digital checklist potentially would look like. And then sharing feelings is also important, not just coming from the counseling lens, but just through being able to make connections with your adolescent. Encouraging your student to share their feelings about how they're doing, how school is, whether it's through a counselor, a teacher, or a staff member in the school, other peers, or just yourself as the parent and guardians. We always say it's important to ask open-ended questions, whether it's about their classes, friends, or activities that they're involved in. Oftentimes, and whether you're a parent or a staff member in the building, at the end of the day, we often ask our students, how was your day? And a typical adolescent response, if you have one in your home now, is simply good or a one-word answer. I always like to follow up with the one-worded answer of whether if an adolescent says it's bad or good, saying, well, what made it a good day? Or what made it a challenging day? And then validating a student's feelings after they've shared those with you. And then last but not least is staying connected. Helping students stay connected with friends and family members and staff members and counselors is increasingly important during this time of year. We've listed some additional ideas for how to stay connected, whether it's digital or in a non-digital format. We also are trying to encourage families as we reopen school in a digital online platform to try to find activities that don't necessarily require a screen, but also ensuring your students' safety.
So kind of to wrap up really what Ms. Philmeyer and Mr. Sowers were just saying, staying balanced and having a schedule and following routines and all that stuff helps you stay balanced. So a couple other things is exercise. So get up, move around. After you might have a couple minute break between breaks between classes. Stand up or find a standing desk or like a counter to stand at for a little bit. Just stretch those legs. Maybe just close your eyes for a little bit, but just getting up and moving and sitting in one spot can kind of get tiring. You might get tired after a little bit. And then keep a consistent sleep wake cycle. So set your alarm, wake up at the same time. Go to bed at the same time, or have a certain thing that you do right before bed that doesn't involve a screen. So read a book, have a conversation with your parents. Just having that regular sleep-wake cycle will really help you be alert during the day. And then have a healthy meal. So when the schedule says lunchtime, have lunch at that time, or have a snack at a certain time. That'll also help you stay balanced and stay and exercise during that time. Stress reducing activities. Don't do something that increases your stress. So maybe you hop off of a class and you go play a video game that you get super mad about. Do something that's going to actually relax you. Try and stay away from something that's going to increase your stress at that time. And then, parents, ask your students about their day. Ask them how it went, or maybe one good thing and one bad thing every night, or something that you are grateful for that happened that day, or someone that you're grateful for. Just have a conversation with them about how their days are going, especially during a stressful time for them potentially. And then let them know it's okay to ask for help. Encourage them to reach out to any one of us or a teacher. Maybe that live session that they had today didn't go so well. Encourage them to reach out to their teacher. Maybe help them draft the first email, and then that can get that conversation going, or have them reach out to us and we can have that conversation with them, with the teacher. And then have them stay connected to their friends at MEH or outside of MEH. Maybe it's sending them an email or get their phone, text them, have maybe their stress reducing activity is having a FaceTime chat with their friend at a certain time every day or every week at a specific time. So they have something to look forward to during the day. And then also following the MEH schedule. So what Ms. Fohmeyer and Mr. Sowers were saying, like follow that schedule, stick to the schedule. It'll really help keep that routine and staying balanced between the school day and then after school's over with, then they get that free time. So they're not feeling like they're doing the same thing. And then there are tips that you can use for students while at home, just other things to do to stay balanced. So exercising, fun activities they can do. And then also reach out to us. If you're feeling like you just want to get out and just be socialized, reach out to us and we can help you in that area as well.
Okay, so in middle school, it's really important to start teaching your student how to advocate. And advocacy is a skill, so it does take some time. And we are here to support your student in that process. Some students will need a lot more support than others, and that's totally okay. But we do ask that you start to encourage your student to send a Schoology message or to set up meetings virtually or in person when we're back in the building with either their school counselors or their teachers. The teachers understand the middle school student. They understand that they're learning how to advocate. They are willing and wanting to support them in this growth process. So at any time, please, let us know, like, hey, Ms. Philmeyer, my child would like to talk to their math teacher. Can you help them? There are definitely times where I will meet with the student. We will game plan what that meeting with the teacher will look like. And then we'll go together and we'll sit together and meet with the math teacher. And I will support that student in a way that feels safe and comfortable for them. On this screen is an example of what the messaging system looks like in Schoology. You can see that there's a message here to Mr. Sowers asking, hey, do you have time to meet tomorrow during flex class? And this is one way that a lot of students like to communicate with the school counselor or their teachers in order to get in touch with them. So you might be wondering, how does my student meet with the school counselor? And when does my student meet with the school counselor? So during the school year, any time that we're in this building, a student can ask to come see their school counselor virtually. There is different ways to access the school counselor, but we are here for your students. Our job is to advocate for them. Our job is to support them. And so the best time kind of depends on what the student has going on, what their needs are. And so whenever the student feels ready and like they need that support, they should reach out, or you of course can help them in that process. And you could shoot us an email and say, hey, Ms. Gilmore, my child would like to meet with you tomorrow to talk about X, Y, and Z. And then Ms. Gilmore would make a point to look for your child or set up a time virtually to touch base. During the virtual schedule, we'll have different times built in. Obviously there's lunch, there's the learning support time, there's still gonna be flex scheduled for them. Or again, if there was an emergency or something that the student felt like they really needed to talk about first thing in the morning, they could send a Schoology message, or you as the parent could email us and we could set up an appointment to talk, you know, sooner than a flex time. Our emails are included here, so you can email the school counselors directly if it's more appropriate for you to start the conversation than for your student to message us through Schoology. We also do video conferences in the spring. I know we did breakout sessions where we met one-on-one, so it was still private with the student, so we got to see them and they were able to see us. I know we also all participated in phone calls. Some students were a little less comfortable with the video, so they preferred a phone call. So we were making phone calls, and others just wanted to message if they just had a few questions. So we were able to just message them. We have plans this year to continue our counseling program virtually. So we will hope to run some groups, and we are working on the logistics and details of that. In the past, we have run newcomer groups for students that are new to Falls Church City. We have run friendship groups for students that are navigating middle school and maybe having a tough time connecting with peers with similar interests. We have run groups that have supported students with anxiety, looking at different coping strategies and helping them learn new ones and learning from one another about what works best for them. And when we run a group, we typically look at the needs of the students. So this year we will most likely be looking at what's popping up, especially as we start in the virtual setting. As a counseling team, we'll reflect back on the feedback we're getting, and then we'll establish some counseling groups and put it out there to all the students and say, if you're interested in participating, let us know. And those counseling groups would most likely be held during flex or the learning activity time during the virtual setting.
I think that's hilarious that we've added a picture of me at what we called campfire chats last school year, working with sixth grade students where they came in and did personalized interviews. A lot of the things that we did when, as Ms. Philmeyer referenced, when we did those as in-person physical school setting, we're reevaluating how we can still stay connected with students. And I think she highlighted a lot of great opportunities that we have. The groups that we've historically run and are building will be run in a virtual sense through that learning support time and student activity time that's built in on the virtual side of the student schedules. And we wanted to conclude by highlighting all the different resources and tips and tricks, and we've referenced throughout the presentation today, but also encouraging families to take a moment When you go back through the slide to see a lot of these hyperlinked information pieces, just to gain a better understanding of all the mental health supports that the division and our building has put forth to support families, not necessarily just during a virtual setting, but when we eventually return to a physical setting. So we have Falls Church City Public Schools Mental Health Information, Family Resource Center. We highly encourage families, if you haven't done it already, to sign up for the middle school PTA. It's a great way to stay connected and form additional relationships with other parents and families in the community, and find out how you can get more actively involved in our school community. The Husky Herald, that's a weekly message. That it's a newsletter that comes from our administrative team, from Miss Valerie Hardy. The sign up is simple, where when you click on the link, it will take you to a website where you enter your email address and click the subscribe button, and then you're automatically enrolled, so you can get all the real up-to-date information about our building specifically, especially right now as we look forward to reopening the school year. We all have Twitter accounts. Highly encourage you to go to the main MEH webpage and see the teachers' Twitter accounts, so you can see the pictures, especially this year, the behind the scene, learning a lot about how the staff members will be navigating teaching in the digital world. And also, we just encourage students to try new things, and as a parent, to allow students to experience setbacks and have a growth mindset as they journey to become an independent adolescent as they navigate through the middle school years. So we encourage you to check back in. And as we kind of come to a close, we want to thank everybody from joining us. I'm going to go ahead and pull up our staff again so you can see our faces one last time, and encourage everyone, when you get the opportunity, if you have generalized questions, we have added a new email address here at hendersonms@fccps.org to answer your general questions you have about our school specifically. And then when we have our virtual settings that we're going to be pushing out more information, we'll be answering all those questions for you. So on behalf of our counseling team, thank you for joining us live today and letting us spend some time and sharing with you a little bit about transitioning students to a middle school. Bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.